This is how to build an MCP server so you can connect your LLM agents into just about anything. The Model Context Protocol was released by Anthropic in November 2024. It addresses a lot of the issues that have been popping up around agents. How? Well, in order for agents to exist, they need tools, right? But every framework or app or client tends to bring its own way of declaring these tools. Now, this becomes a pain because you might find yourself creating integrations repeatedly every time you want to use an AI capability. This is where MCP comes in. It standardizes how LLMs talk to tools. So you can define your tool server once and use it everywhere. I'm going to show you how to build your own in under 10 minutes. But does it only work with paid LLMs? And how hard is it actually to build? And what about observability? Can I track what's using a specific tool? We'll get to that. I'm recording this after a big bowl of carbs and without using Cursor Copilot or my old mate, Stack Overflow. I'm going to break it down into three straightforward steps. Phase one, build the server.
Alrighty, so we are going to go on ahead and build our very own MCP server. And as usual, we're going to set a bit of a timer. So 10 minutes on the clock. Let's kick this thing off. So I've already got, I guess, a little bit of background as to what we're going to be building an MCP server for. So I built a machine learning API in this video where we actually went and deployed it using Fast API. And you can see here that I've currently got it running locally via this specific endpoint. Now, if I go and send this particular body, so years at company, so it's predicting employee churn. So this dictates how many years that particular employee has been at the company, as well as their satisfaction, their position, whether they're a manager or non-manager, and their salary. So I've split this up into an ordinal representation between 1 to 5. So if I send this off, it's going to predict whether or not the employee is likely to churn. So you can see down here that we've got a prediction of 0. If we went and change their employee satisfaction to 0, 1, you can see they're still not going to churn. What if their salary sucked? So if we send that through, they're still not going to churn. So maybe if they had less employees, so maybe they're ultra loyal. So if we change their years at the company, take a look. So we've now got a 1. So that represents the fact that they are going to churn. But how would we convert this into an MCP server so that we can expose it to all of our amazing AI agents? Well, that's exactly what we're going to do with our MCP server. So you can see that I've got my API running here. So that's just what I've shown using Fast API, and I'll include a link to that as well. But for now, we are going to focus on getting our MCP server up and running. Okay, so we want to go on ahead and do this. So, all right, focus. So we're going to go UV init, and we're going to create a employee project. So this is going to now create a folder called employee. It's got my PI project TOML file, so on and so forth. Then what we need to go ahead and do is cd into that folder. So we're now inside it, and we want to go on ahead and create a virtual environment. So I'm going to go uv venv. So we've now got a virtual environment, and then we're actually going to copy this command to activate it. Boom, that is our virtual environment now created. So if we jump in, you can see that we've got our virtual environment. All of our project files were looking good. Okay, what do we want to go on ahead and do now? We need to import or install our dependencies. So we're going to go uv add, and we want our MCP CLI package. And we also want requests. Let's make sure I'm not covering that. So we're actually going to be using the Model Context Protocol. So this is our big library over here, which is going to allow us to do all of this amazing stuff. And there's a whole bunch of information about how this actually works. We're mainly going to be using the Python SDK. Okay, so that is, let's run that install. Perfect, we're now installed. All right, we can clear that. So if we jump into, we also want to create a server file. So I'm going to go touch server.py. Beautiful. Okay, so if we jump in here now, we should have a server file. Okay, that is the beginnings of our server. Very basic at the moment, but we need to go on ahead and build this out. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to import our dependencies. Oh God, the how's our time? Oh my Lord, 7 minutes. Okay, we are going to need to punch it. So we're going to go from mcp.server.fast. MCP. We are going to import Fast MCP, and then we need to import a bunch of other stuff. So we're going to import JSON. So we're going to use this. So this Fast MCP class is going to be like the crux of our entire server. So you'll see when I instantiate that in a second. Then we want JSON. We're going to use that for some parsing later on. We're going to import requests to actually make a request out to this API. And then what do we want? We need a little bit of typing assistance. So we're going to go from typing, we're going to import list, because that's how we're going to pass the input from our agent. Okay, those are our dependencies now done. We're then going to create our server. So I'm going to say MCP is equal to Fast MCP, and we're going to call it churn and burn. Sort of in alignment with my desktop, right? Okay, so then, so that's our server created. And then we want to create a tool. So create the tool. And there's different resource types, right? Or different capabilities that you are able to build inside of your MCP server. So you've got the ability, let me jump back. You've got the ability over down here. So you can build resources, prompts, tools. You can handle sampling, transports. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Okay, so we are going to create a decorator. So we're going to mcp.tool. So this is going to wrap our function that's going to call out to our endpoint. So then we're going to create that specific tool. So we're going to call it predict churn. And it's going to return a string. And we now need to handle the data that we're going to take in. So we're going to take in a argument called data. It's going to be a list of dictionaries. Okay, that's beautiful. So then what we actually need to do is define a doc string. Now I've gone and written this a little bit earlier. So this is what we're going to paste in. So I'm going to copy that and then let's read it for a sec, time permitting. Okay, so this tool predicts whether an employee will churn or not, pass through the input as a list of samples. So the arguments, so data, employee attributes, which are used for inference, the example payload, and you can see I've got a list wrapped, or a dictionary wrapped in a list, and it takes in the exact same variables that we had inside of Postman, where I was over here. Here's a company, employee, sat, position, and salary. Here's a company, employee, sat, position, and salary. And it's gonna return either one, churn, or zero, no churn. Okay, so that's our doc string now created. Now we wanna go on ahead and handle this. So we're gonna create a variable for our payload, and we're just gonna grab the first value that we have inside of our list, right? So we're just accessing this, excluding the list. Okay, then we need to make a call out to our API, 4 minutes. Okay, this is not looking good. So we're gonna go request.post, because remember over here, we're making a post request, and then we are gonna send it actually out to that URL. But if you had an external URL, you'd be going out to that. Let's paste in there. We need some headers. And our headers, I should have practiced some typing this morning. We're gonna accept CCEPT application /JSON. And we are going to specify the content type. Should have toggled word wrap. There we go. All right, a content type is going to be application /JSON. And then we want to pass through our data, which is going to be our JSON dumped payload. Okay, beautiful. All right, so that's our response now set up. Then what we're going to do is we're going to return response.json once the user calls out to this. Okay, so that is our tool now created. Now we just basically need to specify what we do when it gets called out. Actually, if name equals main, we are going to run our MCP server, so mcp.run, and then our transport is going to equal stdio, so standard input output. All right, I'm pausing the timer. All right, so we've got 2 minutes and 47 seconds left, but that is our server now created. So we're good to go.
All right, so we've knocked off phase one and we've got the server up and running, but how do we actually test that it's working? Can we actually get to our tool? Well, this brings us to phase two, testing out the server.
Okay, we're back. So we've gone and created our server, but we haven't really tested it out yet. So how do we go about doing this? Well, I've got 2 minutes, 47 seconds left on the timer. So let's kick this off. So let me show you how to do this. Okay, so we are currently inside of the employee folder. We want to start off the dev server. So this is going to give us access to the MCP inspector. We can actually test out our tools. So we can go UV run MCP dev server.py. This should start off the inspector. I'm going to pause it if we successfully get the inspector up. Okay, that's our inspector up and running. I can copy this URL here. I'm going to go to a browser. I'm going to copy this again. I'm going to paste that in. Beautiful. All right, that's our inspector. So if I connect down here, then if I go to tools up here, then if I go to list tools, that is our tool now running. I'm going to pause it. All right, we've got 2 minutes left. All right, but let me sort of show you, right? So over here, we've got our transport type. So there's two different transport types available. So there's standard input output. There is also SSE, which is service sent event. So this is more important. So you probably use standard input output when you're just connecting with local files or local tools. When you're doing something more client server related, you're probably more default over to service sent events. We're using STDIO or standard input output as dictated based on the fact that right down here under transport, we are specifying that. Tools like Cursor can handle SSE and STDIO. I think Claude Desktop that uses STDIO only. The capability that we're going to use in a second is we're going to do that with STDIO when it comes to using our agent. Okay, enough of me blabbing. So let's jump over to inspector. So to use our inspector, you just make sure you specify the right transport type, the right command, and the right argument. And if you hit connect, you can see that we're connected. Remember how I said there's different capabilities that you can pass through in your MCP server? They're all up here. We're just interested in our tool. And if we hit predict churn, we can actually go and test this out. So if I switch to JSON over here, we can go and pass through an object. So again, I've got one nicely formatted. So we're going to copy this over. Chuck that in here. All right, drum roll, please. So now if we go and hit run tool, take a look, we've got our prediction. So we've successfully gone and determined that this particular employee with these particular values will not churn. Now, if we went and changed it up, so I'm just gonna change it in here because you get this weird thing, not ideal. So when I go and delete values, so like let's say I deleted this, you can see we're getting errors. So it's running through syntax formatting while I'm trying to edit. So we just do that here. So let's say they had not that many years at the company, they weren't all that satisfied and their salary was in the lower quadrant or lower, what is it, fifth? So if I paste that in now, take a look, that particular person will churn. Okay, that is our tool now successfully running and our MCP server successfully working.
Right, so we've now established that our server actually works. We've made a call to it and we're able to get a prediction back as to whether or not somebody's likely to churn or not churn. How do we bring this into an agent? Well, that brings us to phase three, adding it into an agent.
Alrighty, last thing we gotta do. So I've got 2 minutes. Let me bring that back up. 2 minutes left on the timer. All right, so what we now need to go on ahead and do is integrate this into our agent. So I've gone and pre-written up an agent using the BAI framework, and I'll make this available via GitHub, so you'll be able to test that out. This is all built using, let me show you the LLM. So we're using OLLaMA and we're specifically using the Granite 3.1 dense 8 billion parameter model, which is going to be trained by our amazing research team. So we're going to go on ahead and use this. Now, right down the bottom, you can see that I've got this question. So will this particular employee churn? And I've got my employee sample over here. So I've got the years of the company, the employee sat, the position, and their salary. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we can send this over. So we're running out of time. Got minute 14 left. Okay, let's punch this out. So we need to go over to here. We've got our standard input output server param. So we need to pass through our command. So our command is going to be UV. And then we are going to run, we need to pass through directory to specify where our server actually is. And then I just want to go and grab the file path to our server. So I'm going to copy this, copy path, boom, and then back into our agent. And then I'm going to paste that in here. And then we need to go and run our command and we are going to run server.py. And just over here, I just want to get rid of server. Okay, so now if I go and run this, let me just go to another terminal, beautiful. And if I go run Python single flow agent, okay, we've got 30 seconds left. Let's see how we go. Drum roll, please. Take a look. There we go. I'm going to pause it. We had 22 seconds left. Not too bad. Okay, so let's quickly run through this. So right down here, you can see that we've got a thought from our agent. So the user wants to know if their employee will churn based on their attributes. I need to use the predict churn tool. And then right down here, we've managed to get a prediction. So over here, we've got a prediction of 1 indicating that the employee should churn. So what has our agent said? This employee is predicted to churn. So we've successfully gone and built out our MCP server and integrated it into an agent. Almost forgot observability. All you need to do is import logging and add in this line here, and this will give you the ability to see every tool call in your server logs. And in the interest of interoperability, just to prove that this MCP server could be used elsewhere, I can add it to, for example, Cursor by using the following command, which is effectively just the command that we've passed through to our agent. Then I can open up a chat, paste in an example to determine whether or not this particular person will churn, then convert to agent mode and hit send. Then I should be able to run the tool by opening up the example and hitting run tool. And if I scroll on down, you'll see that I've got a prediction of 1, which indicates that that particular employee is going to churn. Same server, MCP everywhere.